Hi, my name is Felino Dolloso, and I'm an actor in Sydney, Australia. There were Six Commandments. It's basically, it's a dark drama, comedy, revenge film about a half-brother and sister who go on a rampage almost, avenging the sisters. And I'm playing the half brother, Aris, who's basically he's a bigger than life character. He's a dark sense of humor. He's got cruel tendencies, vicious individual, but heart of gold. Loves his half sister a lot. So basically, protective and caring towards her. Seven short films, short stories about different. Families and basically it's linked by a certain element. It I guess explores what relationships between parents and their siblings, people from different cultures, basically drawn together in the line so that it sort of zigzags across that line. The directors I worked with, Martin Ponferrada, he directed a film called Callabona Red. That film won an Indie Fest 2009 Merit of Award. The second one, Dicky Tanuwidjaya, he directed The Devil Six Commandments. And that actually won an award, a Merit of Award as well in LA, 2010. And that film is now being sold to AMC Channel by the US distributor. They're brave directors, filmmakers, certainly passionate and focused on telling the story they want to show, to tell. Whether the mainstream audience, they take risks because they're not sure whether the mainstream audience will like it or not, but they still go ahead and do their film. I think it is a challenge with the roles that that I tend to audition for are at this stage, not the meaty roles. I mean, it would be Asian characters, whether it be the bad guys or victims. But to find filmmakers or directors that are actually just would give you the challenge to to prove yourself, to work to your own skills in a major role is great. So this would be Martin Ponferrada, Dicky Tanuwidjaya, Mike Kane is another. They're both hard mediums. I'm kind of a little bit more used to film now. Theater, definitely. They still both require focus and discipline. Theater, it's a bit more nerve-wracking, especially, a lot of adrenaline involved, especially before you go on stage. The rehearsal period. Working on the scenes, working on the character. I mean, it's more time, but I think on stage, once you're on the night, once you're, when you go on, it's just one journey, it's the highway, whether what happens at night, you just have to stay in there. In films, always see the cut and so on. But yeah, both very, very, challenging mediums for me. Yeah. A place called A Quiet Night in Rangoon, written by Katie Pollock, directed by Paul Gilchrist, Subtle Nuance Theater. And it's basically story in Burma, when in the time when there was the political upheaval and the arrest of monks and so on, where was happening. I'd love to play Marcos. I think there's something very interesting about Marcos, especially in the 70s era, how he got to power and how what happened in that decade. Manny Pacquiao, I think the Filipino boxer would be great to play when he's retired and and not sure what he wants to do. That would be the best time maybe to play him. Genghis Khan is another. I'd love to play Genghis Khan. Although a lot of movies have been made about him already, but I think what happened and all that, focusing on the hurt. I like focusing on the hurt of a character, of a role, and and you just work your way from there as a starting point. Then you find nuances, and pathways, and you just add it all up. Yeah, it's a strange way of working, but it's good to start at, I think, at that point.